You may know him from BET's College Hill, along with Love and Hip Hop. Ray Cunningham, also known as Mr. Ray, that's Mr. with two S's. You may also remember him here locally, actually, 93.9 WKYS. Remember him on there? All right, well, he's going to share some words of inspiration through his new number one best-selling book, Mess with a Message, and it's full of tea. Mr. Ray, best-selling author, we should introduce you as first. Congratulations on this new book, Mess with a Message.
Thank you.
What made you want to write this book right now?
I decided to write my book, Mess with a Message. Shout out to it being number one on Amazon for 3 weeks. Today makes 3 weeks consecutively. Wow. So thank you to everybody.
Yes.
I decided to write this because I was home during the pandemic. I was in Atlanta for the entire pandemic. So, you know, technically we were not shut down. We were still open, just moving very cautiously. And it was just so much happening in the world around us with LGBT, with Black Lives Matter. Just everything was just going crazy. I felt like I said, I need to put some energy to some good use. I need to tell my story. There's so many people losing their lives out here every day, and they're not able to tell their story, whether it was inflicted or it was wrong place or wrong time or bad judgment. And I didn't want anybody else to ever tell my story but me, because I always jokingly say my 15 minutes started 15 years ago when I started on BET, and I'm still here working, and I don't look a day over 30. So I wanted to tell my story while I'm still able to be animated and enjoy it and recall everything that, you know, before I forget some stuff and add some stuff in later.
It might make for a more interesting story if you hadn't, right? BET's College Hill, people know you from that. They know you from Love and Hip Hop. But I also, when I was looking at the book, I mean, I didn't know about alopecia. I didn't know you come from a blended family. You have gone through a lot. How do you put all this into one book?
You know what? I've always jokingly said to my friends and to my sisters, specifically my sister Samantha, our family would make a great dynasty spinoff on BET. Like, our family's so blended. You have the bougie, you have the in-betweens, you have the, as I like to call myself sometimes, the black sheep. And I always say the black sheep, meaning I'm the one that, I'm the prodigal son that went away from home, went to Hollywood, started partying a little too much, got a little sidetracked, but I got focused again, aligned myself and walking in my light, as I say. A lot of people didn't know about the alopecia until Love and Hip Hop. I'm filming. I went from having a head full of hair and a full beard to no eyebrows, no beard, no hair. I woke up one day and it was literally just starting to shed, and I finally went to the doctor and I was diagnosed with having alopecia. And it was a matter of during the pandemic. Again, I'm so thankful for the pandemic. I know that sounds crazy to say, but I was able to change my eating habits, change my lifestyle, scale back on some things, and just do pay attention to my body and my mental health more, because I do deal with anxiety and depression. And I was able to finally not be on camera, be myself, focus on the things that I needed to heal from so that I could be a better person and be an inspiration to someone else. And as you see, I got this glow, my hair grew back, I lost some weight, I wrote a book, I enrolled in graduate school. I'm in Virginia State currently, getting my master's in media management. So I did all that online while still filming, being out here in LA as we opened back up, you know, post-pandemic now. Well, we're still kind of in it. We're still in it. Like, if it doesn't look too clean, I'm going to put my mask. I just put my mask on. I'm like, oh, I'm just going to wait till I get outside.
Well, I'm glad you brought up Virginia, because this is actually home to you, D.C. You are no stranger to our city. What do you have to do when you come back? Is there a place that you know about we need to go try out?
Oh, my goodness. When I come to Washington, D.C., I always go to Bus Boys and Poets. I need a D.C. tap water, and I need that blackened salmon with the grit, with the grits. Oh, my God. That blackened salmon with those crab grits are so good. As well, I always go to the Museum Bar. Shout out to my friend, Greg Harrison. He went to Virginia State as well. He has the Museum Bar in D.C., staple there for, you know, urban athletic clothes. But no, for the most part, and then when I come to D.C., my girlfriend, shout out to Dominique the Diva. She's on WKYS. She cooks for me. Whenever I come in town, she cooks. She's a full mom outside of that radio show. So I have a lot of love in D.C. I have a lot of fans. I hate saying fans. I have a lot of friends in D.C. But my family's in Richmond, 804 Richmond all day. And D.C. is a good time for me. See, I'm excited talking about D.C. And I'm looking forward to relocating back to D.C. once my chapter in L.A. is finished.